Hello and welcome to Creative Change Workshops. I'm currently standing in my lockdown living room. My name is Hannah. I am a white woman in her 30s with bright pink hair, bright pink lipstick and a bright pink top. I have blue eyes and I am an artist. I will be your host for the next few weeks. We are going to have 16 weeks of art tutorials followed by live stream interactive show and tell sessions. It's going to be a fabulous time, a great thing for us all to look forward to, and I'm really glad that you can join me. Now today we're going to do our first activity, which is a mixed media piece, and it is based off an idea that I stole with permission from a group called the 64 Million Artists. Some of you may even have been members of that group, which ran a challenge in January, which was such good fun. And we're really pleased to be able to continue this kind of creative community process. So let's get started. Now to begin, you will need scissors, magazines or newspapers, some glue and a piece of cardboard. Now, I've decided that I'm actually going to work on top of a collage that I'd already done. You can use a cardboard box, you can use an old cereal box, you can literally use anything that you've got hanging around, so you don't need to buy loads of expensive resources. And what I'm now going to start doing is looking through these magazines. You can use any magazine that inspires you. And I'm going to start cutting out words that I think relate to positive mental health. So things that are going to be really affirming me and inspiring me. And that is our first step. As you can see, I've got quite a variety of words all cut out here. When we get on to the main activity, I may actually cut these individual words even down smaller than this. But we've got a good selection. Hopefully you have too now. So I'm going to pop these just to the side. And next, I'm going to just paint this board white. Hopefully you've got some white paint or some gesso or something like that, just to create a nice backdrop. You don't have to do this. If you haven't got any paint available, you could literally just do a collage background similar to what I've got on the other side, and then you can continue doing the activity on top of that. So the choice is yours, but to keep it simple, I'm just going to paint this white. While we're waiting for that to dry, I just thought I'd show you this. Now, this is a piece of artwork that I did about a year ago as part of my Neurodivergent Horizons work. But it's actually given me quite a good idea for this. So, as you can see, I actually used my own profile to create the head shape. And I actually based it off MRI images as well, which was quite fun. But today we're going to be trying to get you to take a photograph on your phone of your profile. So if you can find a lamp behind you or something and just literally look to the side and try and capture that outline of your face, because we're going to be using that to draw onto the white cardboard. Now when you're ready to start taking your photograph of your site profile, I suggest that you tilt your head up like that, and you get a much more flattering angle. Just elongates the neck and it's much easier to actually get real definition to your side profile image. Good luck, and we'll see you once our paint is dry and we're ready to put our profile into action. Okay, so our whiteboard is nicely dried now. I've got some black card, but you don't have to have black card. You can use any dark colour. Just use what you've got and adapt to whatever that is. I've taken the picture of my side profile here. Obviously I'm filming from my phone, whereas you could have your phone just next to you to actually copy from. So the next stage is to just create that profile outline. Okay, I'm going to make sure that I'm using my reference. And obviously I'm going to slightly enlarge this. So, just looking at the image. It doesn't have to be perfect. We're just giving a loose outline. It's actually quite interesting because we don't very often look at ourselves from these perspectives. But try not to be critical, because I know a lot of us hate pictures of ourselves. But just focus on the lines and the shapes. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect, but you want it to be reflective of you as an individual. So it's quite good for developing skills, looking at composition and stuff. But a very simple but effective exercise. If you want to, you could do gridding for this as well, which is a technique where you would either on your phone app you could form a grid, or you could draw over to divide the image into squares and then just focus on each square if you re-grid it out on the paper. But it really doesn't have to be precise, so I'm just going for a very quick sketch here, just to give a basic example. Now what I'd like you to do is, if there is a natural hairline already, is to kind of factor that in. So in a traditional silhouette portrait, you wouldn't have this because there would be no details. It would literally just be the black outline. But as we're going to be focusing on adding our word wig in, I think it's quite nice to give a bit of a shape, so we know that when we're gluing, how we want to be positioning it. So, I mean, this is very, very basic, but it gives you an idea. So, as you can see, I've done a very rough sketch based on this side profile picture. So, we don't need that anymore. I will need to get some scissors. And I'm just going to focus on cutting out the main side profile. And again, if you haven't got black cardboard, you can use any kind of dark colour, cereal box or something, as long as it's all in a similar shade or colour. We just want it to be in contrast up against the white backdrop. Now it's really tempting with these to start drawing in details. You can see automatically I started trying to do bits around the nose, the eye, the lips. Ignore that. We want it to be as simple as possible, because our main concept and focus is going to be decorating the hair area with our selected words. So now I'm just going to stick this down to the card and I'm going to begin adding the words. You can see that I started to create a bit more hair-like texture, the sort of waves. Earlier on, when I cut out my black face shape, I also kept hold of this. So what I'm now going to do is put some glue on and reposition it slightly away from the face, leaving this lovely outline. So this is now firmly stuck down, which is brilliant. I decided that I'd like to choose the word wisdom to kind of summarise this picture. So I've cut out individual letters, which I'm now going to stick on here. Here we are. But you can choose any word, really, something that really resonates with you. That could be to do with the mind, that could be to do with well-being, or something that's just really on your heart whilst you're making this. So as I stick those down, just be contemplating what it means to you to kind of purposefully put on that wig of wisdom, or give yourself a check up from the neck up, as my friend David Daniels always says. Sometimes when we're stuck in a rut and we're really struggling, there are some really practical things that we can do that can just shift our perspective. And that might be doing some artwork, just sitting down doing some collage, switching your brain away from that worrying mentality and just focusing on something really practical. It might be that you want to reminisce of some really good times that you've had. Start looking through some photo albums. I know the best thing for me is, if I'm feeling down, is to think about what was the last thing that really made me laugh. Like hysterically, physically, stomach-hurting laugh. And sometimes just revisiting those memories, that little shift of perspective can just really turn things around for us. It's not a solution to everything, we know that, but sometimes it's about just reflecting and getting our emotional needs met where we can. So I'm going to carry on with this, and tomorrow we will begin adding some mixed media. But this is a pretty good start. So it's all dried off and we're ready to start adding our embellishments. Now the word embellishment basically means to pretty things up. Well, that's my translation anyway. If you have any Tippex, can be any brand, this is ideal. Now I love adding just little dots or splodges to just create patterns. So, see if this works. Obviously I'm doing it vertically, which is a bit more tricky, but when you're doing it on a normal table, it should be quite easy. And you can literally just start creating little circles, little blobs, and it really does just make a really nice effect. If you haven't got Tippex, you can just use paint or whatever you've got really. So I'm going to continue doing this up and around the face. You don't have to do that. This is kind of freestyle playtime for you now. But I'll give you some examples of what I'm going to do. Another thing that I might use is the end of a paintbrush dipped in various coloured paint, just to add some little dots with the end of my paintbrush. So not the brush end, the end end. And we'll see how it goes. So I've done the dots there and I'm quite pleased with those. Now my hair at the moment is quite vibrant pink, so I'd like to kind of represent that in this picture. One of my favourite types of paint is this kind of iridescent, transparent paint. I won't tell you the brand, but it's covered in paint anyway. But what you'll find is that as I start to apply it thinly over the top, you'll still be able to see the words through it. So if you haven't got this kind of paint, what you could do is get some PVA glue and add a tiny amount of normal paint, and that will just give it a kind of glossy, transparent effect, so you're not covering up the words. So if you'd like to give it a go, but at the same time, if you're happy with it as it is, keep it as it is. This is completely personal to you, so I don't expect lots of replicas of what I've done. I want it to be a fresh expression that really resonates with you. So she's nearly finished. If you wanted to, you could use metallic marker pens or some more Tippex or a white pen, just to bring out some little highlights in there if you wanted. But sometimes I think less is more. So often I think something's finished and then I'll just add a bit extra and then really regret it. So it's a difficult balance to find. But to complete this, I'm going to add my signature here. And then I'm going to own my picture. And every time I'm feeling a bit flustered, I'm going to look at this and be like, right, I'm going to put my wig of wisdom on. What can I do? What small things can I do to distract myself or to make myself feel slightly better? So I hope this is really helpful for you, and I can't wait to see what you do. I'd love to see your work. Please can you email in to info@hannaharia.com and we'll be able to show your work on our live streams next week. Enjoy creating.